Good morning, dear students. Today we will start chapter 19, graphical representation of data. As you know, this chapter you have studied before and in class 7th. So you know that the two forms which are generally used for presenting data, that is, first one is the tables and second one is the graphs. Okay, so as I told you that you have studied this chapter before also, and you have studied the bar graph. So in this chapter we are going to study two more new topics, that is the histogram and the pie chart. Okay, so first of all, what is bar graph? Bar graph is a pictorial representation of numerical data by a number of bars of uniform width with different heights erected horizontally or vertically with equal spacing between them. You know that it is in bar graph, what we do, firstly it is represented by numerical data, second it is in the uniform width and heights, thirdly it is erected horizontal and vertically with equal spacing between them. Means space is also there, and it may be represented horizontally or it may be represented vertically. So before starting with this chapter, whenever you start the exercise, first try to solve this example question, because on solving this example question, this exercise doesn't contain much more questions related to this bar graph. So first try to solve this example portion and then come in the exercise portion. So with the first one, I am starting with the first exercise, that is 19A. So let's start with the first exercise, that is 19A. In the first question, it is saying the following table shows the number of students in a school playing five different games. So there is a school in there, five different games are played by the student here. So you have to prepare the bar graph here. So what is given? Number of games is given. How many games are there? Five games. And what is the name of the games? First one is the football, second is the hockey, third is cricket, tennis and squash. So number of student playing football is 200, number of playing hockey is 175, number of playing cricket is 250, number of playing student tennis is 75, similarly squash is 50. So we have to prepare the bar graph here. So I will prepare the bar graph here. So in this way I have divided the x-axis and in the y-axis. So scale I will consider here as 50. I will take gap of 50, means this one I will consider as 50. Scale I am taking here as how much? 50. Okay, so I am marking here the number of students. So I will start with 0, here I will get 50, here I will get 100, next I will get 150, another next I will get here 200, then 250, then 300. Okay, then more you want to go, it will be 350, but here it is given till 200 only, na? So you can consider till 250 or 300 also. And here I am taking this one as football, here I am taking one gap, I will write down here as hockey, then one gap, then cricket, then tennis, then squash. So this represent the number of games. So I will write here as number of student. This is number of students. And this horizontal and vertical line, I am naming this one as number of student and the other as number of games. Here I am writing the, sorry, I have written wrong. This is number of games and here is the number of student playing. मीन्स फुटबॉल हॉकी क्रिकेट दिस इज़ द नंबर ऑफ नेम ऑफ द नंबर ऑफ द नेम ऑफ द गेम्स एंड हियर दिस इज़ द नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट एंड नेम्स ऑफ द गेम्स हियर सो सी इन द क्वेश्चन हियर इन द क्वेश्चन इट इज़ गिवन दैट फुटबॉल इज प्लेड बाय हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट 200 स्टूडेंट सो फुटबॉल आई एम टेकिंग हियर फुटबॉल इज हियर हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट हैव प्लेड फुटबॉल सो आई हैव टू प्रिपेयर अ ग्राफ हियर सो 200 स्टूडेंट्स आर प्लेइंग ग्राफ सो राइट डाउन लाइक दिस यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर द बार ग्राफ ओके एंड शेड दिस So how many students they are playing football with this graph you will be clearly it is clearly visible that 200 students are playing what they are playing football you can do with the help of scale also better do with the help of the scale now how many students are playing hockey 175 so this is 150 and this is 200 so 75 will come between this is 10 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 and here you will get somewhat, here you will get what? 75. So here 75 is there. This is 75. So how many students are playing hockey? There are 100. 75 students are playing hockey so in this way you can prepare the graph okay next is cricket how many students are playing cricket 250 so here 250 will come prepare a bar graph this is 250 now Tennis, how many students are playing there? 75 students playing tennis. So 75 will come between 50 and 100. So this is 50. Then 50, this is 55, then this is 60. Then after that 65, then 70, then here 75 will come. So here you will get 75 students playing tennis. Okay, next is number of student playing squash is 50. So squash you will get here only. This is 50. Number of student playing squash is how much? 50. Now shade it like this. If you don't want to shade, it is okay. But if you will shade, it will look much beautiful. So here we have prepared the bar graph here. So here what we have written the names of the name of the game and here the number of students are given and according to the given table we have prepared this bar graph here. So this was question number 1 of 19th A. This is question number 2 of this first exercise 19A and here you have to Find the question it is given. The following table shows a student spend his pocket money during the course on a month. Here it is given. This table it shows that a student is spending his pocket money during the course of a month. In a month, how many pocket money he spend that student spend it is given. First item is given that is food, entertainment, other expenditures and saving. Next What is given? Expenditure. In food, he spent 40%. In entertainment, he spent 25%. In other expenditures, he spent 20%. And in saving, his saving is how many? 15%. So, in a month, na? So, if the pocket money is 1000, rupees 1000, represent the above information on our table showing expenditure in rupees, then we have to prepare the bar graphs. Firstly, his the money he is spending that is not given, in rupees it is given in percentage. First we will convert this percentage into rupees. So first, what is given to you? We are given with items such as, are you able to see here, such as food. First is food. In food he is spending 40%. Second, entertainment, he is spending 25%. Third, other expenditure, he is spending 20%. And savings is how many? 15%. And what is the total pocket money he is getting? He is getting rupees 1000 rupees. So we have to find out the rupees. We have to first convert this percentage into rupees. So in food he is spending 40%. So I can write down this as 40% of 1000. So 40% of 1000 means 40/100 into 1000. This 2 0 and this 2 0 is there. So 400 rupees he is spending in food. Similarly for entertainment, calculate, that means 25% of 1000. So 25/100 into 1000, this 2 0 and this 2 0 get. So 250 rupees in entertainment. Similarly, other expenditure is spending 20. So 20% of 1000 is 20/100 into 1000. So how much? 200 rupees. And 15% of 1000 is 15/100 into 1000. So this two. So 150 rupees. Okay. So from here we can calculate. So here sir, see, in food he is spending how much? 4400 rupees. In entertainment he is spending 200 rupees here, and in other expenditure he is spending 200 rupees, and in savings he is having 150 rupees, and the total amount is how much? 1000 rupees. So let's calculate. 400 plus 250, 200, and what is 150 is there. Add this, you will get 448 and 19, and this 1000. So total how many rupees is having? 1000 rupees. According to this you have to prepare the bar graph here. So we will prepare the bar graph here. Okay, so in this question I'm preparing the bar graph here. So firstly I will write down the names of the food item here. That is food items. Items I am writing here. This will represent the items, and here it will represent the expenditure. Okay. You can use the scale also. Better use the scale. Okay. So as we have got the number of rupees here, that is in food he is spending 400 rupees, in entertainment he is spending 250 rupees, in other expenditure he is spending 200 rupees, and in saving he is spending 150 rupees. So total if you will calculate, you will get 1000 rupees which he was having as his pocket money for 1 month. So regarding this, we will prepare this bar graph. So draw horizontal and vertical line, that is x-axis and the y-axis. Take a scale of 50. That means 1 unit is equal to how much? 50 rupees. Okay. So from here I will represent the number of items, and here expenditure. Okay, this is the number of items here, and here we will represent the expenditure that is spent in a month. So I told you take the scale of 50. So 50, 100, 150, 200, 250, 300, 400, 350, 400, 450, 500. Okay, now see, in food he is spending how much? 400 rupees. So here I will write down the name of the items. So food, entertainment, next is other expenditure, and the third one is the fourth one is the saving here. Okay, now in food he is spending how much rupees? 40%. So 40% of 1000 is how much? 400 rupees. So 400 rupees you will get 350, and this is 400. Prepare a bar graph here. So this is 400. Use sharp pointing pencil here. Now next it is given for entertainment, it is 25%. He is spending 25% for entertainment. So 25% of 1000 is 250 rupees. So for entertainment, 250 rupees you will get here. So prepare the bar graph for this. This is 250 rupees spending in entertainment. Next is other expenditure, is 20%. 20% of 1000 is 200. So you will get 200 rupees. This is 200 rupees. Similarly, in saving he is spending 15%, and 50% of 1000 is how much? 150 rupees, which you will get here. Okay, so this is the bar graph we have prepared. Either you can leave it like this or you can shade it. Okay, so in this way we have completed the question number 2 bar graph. Now this is question number 3. Here it is given alongside is graph showing the area in 1000 square miles. This is the graph. This is showing area that is in 1000 square miles of 5 given Great Lakes. 5 Great Lakes, first one is the Ontario Lake, the Erie Lake, Michigan Lake and Huron Lake, and third last is the Superior Lake. Okay, so what it is showing? It is showing the graph showing the areas. Means areas, here it is given the areas and here it is given the name of the lakes. These lakes are showing how many areas they cover. So that area is in how much? In 1000 miles, 1000 square miles area is there. Okay, so first looking at this graph you have to answer this question. So first question is, how many square miles of area is represented by 1 centimeter block of the vertical axis? So look at this vertical axis. Here you are having one block and this 1 centimeter block, this will represent how much? From here, if you can take 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, these are like 5000 square miles. Next in is 10,000 square miles, because it is given in 1000 square miles. So this 5000 square mile, 10,000 square miles, 15,000 square miles, 20,000 square miles, 25,000 square miles, 30,000 square miles, and 35,000 square miles. So in 1 centimeter block, on 1 centimeter of block, how many square miles are represented? So how many square miles are represented? 5000 square miles. So this is 1 centimeter block. So from here only you can see how many? 5000 square miles. So 1 centimeter of block represent how much? 5000 square miles. Similarly, the area of the largest lake is about how many times the area of the smallest lake. So from here in the graph you can see the superior लेक हाउ मच 32,000 स्क्वायर माइल्स एंड दिस इज द लार्जेस्ट वन एंड व्हाट इज द स्मॉलेस्ट लेक हियर दैट इज ओंटारियो लेक दैट इज 7,500 स्क्वायर माइल्स सो ऑल्सो नेम द स्मॉलेस्ट एंड लार्जेस्ट लेक सो स्मॉलेस्ट इज द ओंटारियो एंड थर्ड लार्जेस्ट इज द सुपीरियर लेक सो द एरिया ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट लेक इज अबाउट हाउ मेनी टाइम्स सो इफ यू सी दिस इज 7,500 एंड दिस इज 32,000 सो इट इज नियर अबाउट हाउ मच 4 टाइम्स द लार्जेस्ट वन ओके सो हाउ मच नियर अबाउट 4 टाइम्स एंड द स्मॉलेस्ट वन इज ओंटारियो एंड द लार्जेस्ट वन इज सुपीरियर लेक ओके नाउ द थर्ड क्वेश्चन इज हाउ मच इज लेक ईरी लार्जेस्ट इन एरिया देन ओंटारियो लेक दिस इज लेक ईरी दैट इज 10,000 एंड ओंटारियो इज 2,500 सो हाउ मच लार्जर इज दिस सो इफ आई सब्ट्रैक्ट 10,000 फ्रॉम 7,500 आई विल गेट 2,500 स्क्वायर माइल्स सो हाउ मेनी टाइम्स इट इज लार्जर देन ओंटारियो लेक 2,500 स्क्वायर माइल्स between which two lake is the difference in area the least between which two lake see in Mikagang lake and Huron lake here you will get the least difference so between which two lake Mikagang lake and Huron lake now see in the question number 4th here it is saying this double column graph compares the average number of hours of electrical appliances there this is double column graph okay means two graph are there one will represent the weekday and second will represent the weekend used on weekends weekday and weekends read the graph and answer the following looking at the graph you have to answer the following question so which appliance has got the maximum usage from the graph you have to see which appliance is used the maximum here so from here you can see this refrigerator it is 24 So how much from the graph only you can see that which appliance has got the maximum usage that is the refrigerator okay so you can write here as the refrigerator I'm writing here refrigerator which appliance is used twice as many hours on the weekend as it is used on the weekday in weekend which appliance is used twice as many hours means it will be suppose it is 4 so it will be 8 if it is 2 it is 4 so here you can see computer in weekday it is used 4 and in weekend it is the double of 4 so what is the answer here computer here 2 4 8 these are representing the number of hours here what is the average number of hours an AC is used on weekday So see, look at the AC. This is weekday. It is asking what is the average number of hours used in the weekday. So weekday is represented by this. So weekday, you will see how many hours? 16 hours. So 16 hours is the average number of hours an AC is used in on weekday. Which appliances are used for 6 more hours on a day on weekend than a weekday? Okay. So you have to find out which appliances are used six more hours on a weekday than a weekend. So here if you can see it is light, 6 more hours and AC, 6 more hours. So what will be the answer? Light and AC. So with this we finish the exercise. Go through the example first. Try to solve this example first because we are not having much questions in the exercise. So first solve all these examples and after solving this, go to the exercise and then solve the multiple choice question. I hope you enjoy this chapter because this is very interesting chapter. So with this, I finish this exercise. Have a nice day, all of you.